Okay, we're live.
Sorry, focusing on what I've got ahead of it.
Viking Age blacksmith be much different in the Norse area, in the Norse era, than, you know, maybe a 19th or 18th century blacksmith?
Well, during the Viking Age, there was a lot of iron in the peat, and you know, Norway, the Scandinavian countries were preying. They would have extracted the iron from the peat, and refined it to it was used. Later centuries, over the years in the Iron Age, the process was much better refined and made it easier. They found areas in the world that were much more accessible as far as iron content. During that time, iron was, because of all the work that went into extruding the iron and refining it and making it usable, iron was very expensive. You know, the time involved in refining it, that it was usually used on smaller things, spears, axes. Later, as they were, the process.
Their iron might not have been good enough for swords in the Norse era much,
actually,
right?
Most of the swords during that age, a sword would have been equivalent to even now a year or more labor wages. Yeah. Swords really weren't that plentiful as far as during the Viking Age until the Vikings, the Danes or Rus or whichever area and whichever direction they went, went to raid. The Danes that came into England, the Saxons made great swords in England, or what is now modern day England. It wasn't even, they were several countries with different kings during that time in what is now Great Britain or England. But because their access to the iron, they were very skilled, and the Frisians, which later became the French, were skilled at making swords. Most of what was made as far as the Vikings before they did raid into England or into what is now Russia, tools, hammers, like I said, spears, everything multifunction, axes, which oddly enough you see them used as weapons, but they were common everyday tools. Spears could be used for hunting, etc. So hammers, the war hammers and stuff, they were tools that were used on their farms. Swords had one purpose, and it was for killing, battlefields. So, but because of the expense of swords, and it wasn't as plentiful as it is today, only one in maybe 100 people would have a sword. It would usually be your jarls or, your leaders, what we can think of as royalty. Your higher ranking officials would have had swords. Most of the common men would have had axes. Spears were the most common weapon. Then, down into hammers, pitchforks, whatever was available. Most common weapon during that time is a stick.